1 जनवरी 2021 मॉर्निंग मुरली ओम शांति बाप दादा मधुबन स्वीट चिल्ड्रन यू हैव टू गो टू द प्योर वर्ल्ड देयरफॉर कॉन्क्वर लस्ट द ग्रेट एनिमी बिकेम कॉन्क्वरर्स ऑफ लस्ट एंड देयर बाय कॉन्क्वरर्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड क्वेश्चन व्हाट विजन कैन यू गिव एवरीवन थ्रू your activity. Answer, each one of you can give a vision as to whether you are a swan or a stork through your activity. Swans never cause anyone sorrow. Storks cause sorrow because they are vicious. Your children are now becoming swans from storks. The duty of you children who are becoming those with divine intellects is to make everyone else into one with a divine intellect. Om Shanti. When you say Om Shanti, you remember your original religion. You also remember your home, but you mustn't just sit at home. You are the children of the Father, and so you definitely have to remember your heaven. So by saying Om Shanti, all of this knowledge enters your intellect. I, a soul, am an embodiment of peace. I am a child of the Father, the ocean of peace. The Father who establishes heaven is making us into embodiments of purity and peace. The main aspect is purity. It is the world that becomes pure and impure. Not a single vicious person exists in the pure world. The five vices exist in the impure world, and that is why this world is called a vicious world. That is the viceless world. While coming down the ladder from the viceless world, you come into the vicious world. That is the pure world, and this is the impure world. That is the day happiness. This is the night of wandering. In fact, no one wanders at night, but devotion is said to be like wandering. You children have now come here to attain salvation. Your souls were full of all those sins. You had the five vices. Of those, the main vice is lust. It is through this that human beings became sinful souls. Everyone knows that he or she is an impure and sinful soul. Because of the one vice of lust, all qualifications are ruined. This is why the Father says, conquer lust and you will become conquerors of the world. Which means the masters of the new world. Therefore, you should have that much happiness in you. When human beings become impure, they don't understand anything. The Father says, you shouldn't have any of the vices. The main vice is lust. And it is because of this vice that there is so much upheaval. There is so much peacelessness in every home. There are cries of distress everywhere. Why are there cries of distress in this world? Because they are sinful souls. It is because of the vices that they are called devils. You now understand that nothing in this world is useful. The haystack has to be set on fire. Whatever you can see with your physical eyes is going to be set blaze. Souls cannot be set on fire. It is as though souls are always insured. They are always alive. Does anyone even insure a soul? Bodies can be insured. Souls are imperishable. It is has been explained to you children that this is a play. Souls reside up above and are completely separate from the five elements All the things of the world are created from the five elements. Souls are never created, they always exist. It is just that they became charitable souls and sinful souls. These names are given to souls. Charitable soul or sinful soul, soul became so dirty because of the five vices. The Father has now come to liberate you from all sins. It is the vice that ruin the whole character. People don't even understand what a good character is. This is the highest on high spiritual government. Instead of you being called the Pandava government, you can be called the godly government. You understand that you are the godly government. What does the godly government do? It makes souls pure and changes them into deities. Where else would deities come from? No one knows this. Deities are also human beings. But how did they become deities and who made them that? Deities only exist in heaven. Residents of heaven definitely became residents of the hell. And then they became residents of heaven once again. You didn't know this, and so how could anyone else know it? You now understand that the drama is predestined and that all of the souls are actors. Keep all of these aspects in your intellects. You should have the study in your intellects, and you also definitely have to become pure. It is very bad to become impure. It is souls that became impure. They continue to become impure with one another. It is your business to make the impure pure. Become pure and you will go to the pure world. You souls understand this. If there is no soul, the body cannot remain and cannot respond. You souls understand that originally you resided in the pure world. The Father has now explained how you became completely senseless and that this is why you became worthy of the impure world. Now, until you became pure, you cannot become worthy of heaven. Comparison with heaven is made at the confluence age. There is no comparison made there. It is only at this confluence age that you receive all the knowledge. You receive a weapons with which to become pure. Only the one is called the purifier Baba. You tell him, make us pure like them. They are the masters of heaven. You know that you were the masters of heaven. And then while taking 84 births, you became impure. This one has been named Shyam Sundar. They make dark blue images of Krishna, but they don't understand the meaning of that. You receive such a clear understanding of Krishna. They have shown two worlds, but in fact, there aren't two worlds. There is just the one world. It becomes new and then old. At first, a baby is new, and then as he grows up, he becomes old. You beat your heads so much to explain to them. You are establishing your own kingdom. Lakshmi and Narayan also understood this. Did they not? They became so sweet by understanding this. Who explained to them, God, there is no question of a war. God is so sensible and knowledgeful. He is so pure. All human beings go and bow down in front of an image of Shiva. But they don't know who he is or what he does. They simply continue to say, Shiva Kashi Vishwanath Ganga means temple of Shiva at Kashi, where the Ganges emerge from the Lord of the world. They don't understand the meaning of that at all. When you explain to them, they say, what can you explain to us? We have studied all the Vedas and scriptures.
However, no one knows what the kingdom of Ram is. The golden age, the new world is called the kingdom of Ram. Those of you who imbibe this are also number wise. Some of you even forget this because your intellects are completely like stone. So it is the duty of those with divine intellects to make others the same. Those with stone intellects will continue with the same activity. This is because there are swans and storks. Swans never cause anyone sorrow. Stork causes sorrow. Some behave completely like stork and they have all the vices. Many very vicious ones comes here too. They are called devils. They cannot be recognized. Many vicious ones go to the various centers. They make excuses saying that they are Brahmins, but that is a lie. This is called the world of the lies. The new world is the world of truth. It is now the confluence age. There is so much difference. Those who tell lies and do everything false became third grade. There are first grade and second grade too. The father says you have to give the complete proof of purity. Some says it is impossible to live together and remain pure. Therefore, you children have to explain to them because some don't have any power of yoga. They aren't fully able to explain something as easy as this. No one explains to them that it is God who is teaching us here. He says, by becoming pure, you will become the masters of heaven for 21 births. That is the pure world. There cannot be anyone impure in the pure world. The five vices don't exist there. That is the viceless world and this is the vicious world. We are receiving the sovereignty of the golden age. Therefore, why should we not become pure for one part? We are winning such a huge lottery. This is why there is so much happiness. Deities are pure. Only the Father makes you pure from impure. Therefore, you should tell them that you are given this temptation. Only the Father makes you become like them. No one but the Father can make the world new. Only God comes to change humans into deities. This night of his is remembered. It is said knowledge, devotion and disinterest. Knowledge and devotion are each for half the time. After devotion, there is disinterest. You now have to return home. Therefore, you have to shed your costumes, your bodies. You must no longer live in this dirty world. The cycle of 84 births has now come to an end. We now have to return to the pure world via the arrow of peace. First of all, you mustn't forget the aspect of Alpha. You children also understand that the old world is to be destroyed. The Father is establishing the new world. The Father has come many times to establish heaven. Hell is to be destroyed. Hell is so big and heaven is so small. In the new world, there is just one religion, whereas there are innumerable religions here. Who established the one religion? It wasn't Brahma who did that. Brahma becomes impure and then pure. You wouldn't say of me, the impure one, who becomes pure. When they are pure, they are called Lakshmi and Narayan. There is the day of Brahma and the night of Brahma. This one is Prajapita. Shri Baba is called the eternal creator. The word eternal refers to the Father. The Father is eternal and therefore souls too are eternal. The play is also eternal. The drama is predestined. The self, the soul, receives the knowledge of the beginning, the middle and the end of the whole duration of the world cycle. Who gives this? The Father. You belong to the Lord and Master for 21 births, and you then became orphans in the kingdom of Ravan. It is then that everyone's character is spoiled because the vices enter. However, it isn't that there are two worlds. People believe that hell and heaven exist at the same time. Everything is now being explained to you children so clearly. You are now incognito. Look at what has been written in the scriptures. They have completely tangled everything up. No one but the Father can untangle everything that is tangled. People call out to him, I am of no use. So come and purify me and reform my character. Your characters are being reformed so much. However, when it comes to others, instead of being reformed, they are becoming even more spoilt. Everything can be known from one's behavior. Today, someone may be called a Maharathi or a Swan, whereas tomorrow he becomes like a stork. It doesn't take long. Maya is incognito. Anger is not visible either. When someone starts barking, it emerges and it is then visible. Then those who were amazed by listening to the knowledge and relating it to others run away. They fall so far. They became completely like stone. There is the story of the court of Indra. Such ones can be recognized. They should not come into this gathering. Anyone who has received even a little knowledge will go to heaven, because knowledge is never destroyed. The Father says, you now have to make effort and claim a high status. If you indulge in vice, your status will become degraded. You first became part of the Sun dynasty, then the Moon dynasty, and then the Merchant dynasty, and then the Shudra dynasty. You now understand how the cycle turns. They say that there are still 40,000 years of the Iron Age to go. You have to come down the ladder. If it were another 40,000 years, there would be so many human beings. In just 5,000 years, there are so many human beings that there isn't even enough to eat. Therefore, if there were that many thousands of years more, the population would expand so much. So the Father comes and gives you patience. Impure human beings continue to fight one another. Their intellects cannot turn towards this side. Look how much your intellects have changed. In spite of that, Maya definitely deceives you. You have to become completely ignorant of the knowledge of all desires. If there are any desires, everything is lost. You became completely worth not a penny. Maya continues to deceive even very good Maharathis in one way or another. They cannot then climb into the heart, just as some cannot climb into their parents' hearts. Some children are such that they even kill their Lokic parents. They even kill their family. They are very sinful souls. Look at what Ravan does. This world is very dirty. You mustn't attach your heart to it. A lot of courage is needed to become pure. Purity is the main thing needed to claim the prize of the sovereignty of the world, and that is why you tell the Father to come and purify you. Achha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bab Dada. The spiritual father says, Namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says, Namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Essence for the Dharana.
First point, in order to be saved from being deceived by Maya, become completely ignorant of the knowledge of all desires. Don't attach your heart to this dirty world. Second point, give the complete proof of purity. The highest character is that of purity. In order to reform yourself, you definitely have to become pure. Blessing, may you be introverted and experience the divine activities of the subtle powers with your concentrated form. Explanation, the basis of concentration is introverted. Those who are introverted experience the power of divine activities within themselves. To invoke souls, to have heart-to-heart conversation with souls, to transform the sanskars and nature of souls, to have a connection with the Father. In order to do such spiritual service in the world of souls, increase your power of concentration. By doing this, all types of obstacles will automatically finish. Slogan, to imbibe all attainments in the self and be revealed on the world stage is the basis of revelation. Om Shanti.